I said the longitude is given to you to distract you, so you just make use of that. So you have r equals to 6400 times cos 48 degrees. So we have cos 48 degrees times 6400. So this one will give us 4,282.4 kilometers. So that is how to determine that when a longitude is given to you in this respect, you don't need the longitude. Now, distance on great circles. For a distance to be on a great circle, the two positions connecting the distance must either be on the equator or on the same longitude or latitude, as the case may be. Example 1 and example 2 are shown in figure 1.1b to justify that. But before we approach the example 1 and example 2 in figure 1.1b, it should be noted that you will need to recall that there is a relationship between speed and distance, and speed is equal to distance over time. The speed equals to distance over time. That is why it is measured. If the distance is in kilometer and the time is in hours, so automatically the speed will definitely be kilometer per hour. So we must note this, because subsequently we will need this formula to solve some questions. So we have figure 1.1b. Find the distance between this and this. So you have example 1 in figure 1.1b. Find the distance between, so we are given A to be 56 degrees south. We are given A to be 56 degrees south, 80 degrees east. Then we are also given B to be 65 degrees north, 80 degrees east. If you look at these two points, we discover that the latitudes are different while the longitude remain the same. So this is, we want to calculate distance along great circles. And if you are to calculate distance along great circles, we have distance along great circles. The formula for distance along great circle is equal to theta over 360 times 2 pi capital R. That is the formula for calculating distance along great circle. Then what would definitely be our theta here? Our theta here would definitely be, we have it in different directions. So automatically our theta here we have the latitude in different direction. So our theta here would definitely be this divided by 360 times, so we have this multiplied by 2 multiplied by 22 multiplied by 6400 divided by 7. So automatically, since we have it here, so automatically our theta here is along the, this is along the great circle, which is longitude. So we have 80. Then we have R to be 6400 kilometers. Our pi is 22 over 7. Our pi is 22 over 7. So here, it should be noted that since our latitude, we have different direction, and it has been stated in the question that when you have different direction, you are meant to add. Then when you have the same direction, you are meant to subtract. So here we can, it can be, the point will definitely be, so the first thing we have to do here to be sure of what we are doing is to draw the sphere and try to locate our point. We draw the sphere and try to locate our point. And by so doing, we have, this is our meridian, and let's say this is our equator. Then we have 80 degrees east, so it will be like this. Let's say this is our 80 degrees east. Then we have 56 degrees south. 56 degrees south, so it will be somewhere here. We have 56 degrees south. Then 65 degrees north. So 65 degrees north is somewhere here. At 65 degrees north. This is our north pole, this is our south pole, this is our east, and this is our west. So automatically that means the point, this point is B, point where they intersect is B, and this point is our A. So our interest now, since it's along the great circle, we trace it to the center. We trace it to the center. That's why drawing the diagram give us the clue. So automatically, what do we have here? We have 56 degrees south, and we also have 65 degrees. So the theta here. So we are going to have something like this here will be 65. This here will be 56. So automatically, if we produce this, it will look like this. Where this will be our A. This will be our B, this will be our A, and let's say this will be center O. So we have to calculate BOA, which is our theta. And that will definitely be, theta will definitely be 65 plus 56, simply because they are of different direction. So that is why drawing the diagram is really very important, is very important, so as to enable you to determine your theta without making mistakes. So here we have our theta to be 65 plus 56. So automatically theta will definitely be 1, 1, 2, 1. So that's our theta. So now if you have to apply our formula now, which is distance along great circles. Distance along great circle, which is equal to theta over 360 times 2 pi r. Remember, it should be noted that it is capital R once it is distance along great circles. So automatically we have 121 over 360 times 2 times 22 over 7 times 6400. And that would definitely be times 44 times 6400 divided by 7. So this will give us 13,521.3 kilometers. So this is the answer to the question, that is example 1, when we are asked to determine, to find the distance between this and this. So to find the distance between the point A and point B, you know the distance will definitely be along the longitude. The distance from here to here will definitely be along the longitude. And since it's along the longitude, that means it's also distance along great circle. And the formula for calculating distance along great circle is theta over 360 times 2 pi r. And our answer is 13,000. 521.3 kilometers. Example 2. We have two points, P and Q, as shown on the board, are on the Earth's surface. If it takes an aircraft 14 hours to fly from P to Q, full stop, calculate its speed correct to the nearest kilometer per hour. So this one has to do with speed. So the first thing we have to do here is to determine the distance. Having gotten the distance, then we'll now apply the formula relating distance and speed to determine the speed. So the first thing is to draw the diagram. Whenever a question is given to you on longitude and latitude, the first thing you have to do is to draw the diagram. So say 2 point P. So the P has been given. Point P is 32 degree north, 47 degree west. Then Q is 59 degree south, 47 degree west. So these are the 2 points that are given. So automatically the first thing we do is we draw the diagram. That's the first thing we have to do. We draw the diagram. The diagram. Not that okay. So we draw the diagram. So having drawn the diagram, then we indicate our Greenwich meridian and our equator. We have